A demand forecast is created to make a demand for the MRP planning that is used in the requisition worksheet or the planning worksheet. So when calculating the demands and suggesting orders for purchase and production and transfer, the demand forecast will create a fictive demand if we don't have sales orders for that period. Normally, demand forecast will be created if your lead time on the outbound side, on the sales side, is required to be much smaller than the lead time on the inbound side. So if you have a long purchase lead time and a small sales lead time, you can create sales forecast or demand forecast to help with that. So let's see how it works. You can define different demand forecasts. Some people are doing it per year, some are doing it rolling. It we suggest normally to do a rolling demand forecast, but in this scenario it's per year, and you define what period would you like to work with forecast in. Be aware to use the same period all the time. So normally we suggest month for our customers, or we experience that our customers is mostly using month. So I can see here my forecast on, for instance, my city bike is 90 pieces in May. And if I change that here to 92 pieces, what it actually does is it's creating a new entry. I can drill down into it and see here that on this date somebody created a new entry with 2 pieces. So it's actually locking the changes when you change the forecast entries. So that's very nice. You can forecast on sales items or component items, meaning if you change the view to view component item, so that's the demand coming from a production order component line. You could also here forecast maybe 12 as a component item, meaning if you're viewing both of them. We can see a forecast of 104 on this city bike. And of course, again, if we view only the sales item, we would just see the 90 pieces. So the forecast is written down by sales orders, the sales forecast amount, and by production order component lines, the component amount. Therefore, it serves as a demand for component lines and sales line. And you have to be aware that the forecast is working in a specific period, so the forecast for May will only write down or being written down by the demands in May. So it will always display 104 here in the view for both of them, meaning 90 from sales forecast and whatever from component forecast. But when it calculates in the MRP journal in the period of May, it will see what do we actually have of sales orders and quantities sold and take them out of the amount. So if we have sold and have on open sales orders 100 pieces in May, the forecast effect will be only 4. We have other videos on planning to explain more detailed how that works. Be aware that you cannot change the forecast when you have forecast type both, because you need to tell the system if it's forecast, if it's based on a sales item or a component. So therefore, if I change my quantities now, I will just get a validation result. So if I want to change the component, the forecast, I need to select one of them. Now, if I want to view by another period, maybe by week, I can see that the forecast is actually on week 18, but maybe the first date of week 18, Monday in week 18, is not on the 1st of May. So if I'm changing my forecast here to, for instance, 100 pieces, it tells me that we have some conflict of the forecast entry, so suggest to move it till the start of the period, because if you don't do this, you'll have some problem. Let me show you here. Now we say 100, and if I view it per day, I can see now the forecast is on the 29th of April. If I've said no to that, I will have a quantity here on the 29th of April and another quantity remaining on May, meaning my forecast period from April would only be, or for 29th of April would only be 2 days. So I have to be aware of using theoretically the same period for all forecasts. That would be the best thing to do. Normally, if you use location, you would forecast per location. All these forecast entries that I've made here is with no location code. So here I can see the location code is not filled in, meaning it will only create demand on location blank, so to speak. So the normal way would be to, if I go back on my month view, to forecast per location. So maybe you have a main location you're working on, or you should at least be forecasting per different location, because the MRP planning in both the requisition worksheet and planning worksheet will run per location no matter what you do. So here, if I'm forecasting 20 in May on that location, it will now display 20. And if I remove my location filter, 1st of May, it will display 110. This means if I now add to my forecast here, I will get an error, because in real life some of these entries are now with the location code and some of them are not. So now it's not possible to enter here without either saying location code blank, displaying the quantity on the blank location, or location code simple one, etc. So be aware of how you enter this forecast. All these parameters go into the MRP planning in the requisition worksheet and the planning worksheet.